It's so great to have you back, Dr. Murthy, not only as America's doctor. And I feel like we all wish we could book an appointment with you, maybe even a house call. That would be great. I guess this is the closest we're going to get to a house call. But you're also a dad of two and one who is under 4 years old. So that's an important point. For so many parents and grandparents, I have to add, of under fives, this has been a moment we have been waiting and waiting and waiting for. And we are so excited and we're ready to pop the cork on the vaccine caps. I think figuratively, because I don't think they actually have corks, but others are understandably less sure. Every parent, no matter how excited they are or how ambivalent they are, has lots and lots of questions. And we're hearing so many questions from the What to Expect community, as you can imagine. And I think we should start with the basics, which is, why is it so important for babies and toddlers to get vaccinated against COVID, even though they don't have as high a risk of serious infection?
Well, Heidi, I'm so glad you asked. And, you know, I think of this first and foremost as a dad myself. My kids are 4 and 5. They are certainly the age where they, over the last few years, have been getting lots of vaccines. And, yes. And I don't want to have to give my child a vaccine unless they really need it. So why are we recommending these COVID vaccines for kids? Well, here's what's important to know. Even though kids do better than older adults when it comes to bad outcomes with COVID-19, lower risk doesn't mean they're not at risk. And in fact, if we look at the data from the last couple of years, we've seen a couple of things very clearly. One is that COVID is not the flu for our young children. In fact, we've had in the last couple of years, nearly 30,000 kids under the age of 5 who have been hospitalized for COVID-19. We've actually lost, sadly, hundreds of kids under the age of 5 to COVID-19. And these are numbers that are higher than what we typically see with the flu, keeping in mind that we've been taking precautions during these last couple of years. And, you know, the same type of precautions that would normally prevent respiratory viruses from spreading. The fact that so many kids have gotten ill tells you just how contagious this virus is and how consequential it can be as well. So that's why it's important to protect our children. And I should also important to know that we vaccinate our kids right now for illnesses that are less deadly than COVID-19, because we want to do everything we can to prevent death and illness in our kids. Right now, COVID is the fifth leading cause of death among children under 5. And so this is why the vaccine is such a big deal, because it gives us an opportunity to protect our kids against the worst outcomes of COVID-19.
And we take, as parents, every opportunity we can possibly take to keep our kids safe and healthy. So this is just yet another way we can do that.
One more thing that's really important for parents to know is it's hard to tell from the outside which of our kids are going to run into trouble with COVID-19. Because mm-hmm. when you look at the kids under 5 who have been hospitalized, about half of them actually don't have pre-existing conditions that might put them at increased risk. And so this is why I would urge parents, regardless of whether your child has other illnesses, medical conditions or not, to get them vaccinated against COVID-19.
That's such an important point. But I guess the question everyone also has is, how do we know that it's safe? You're getting your daughter vaccinated right away. How do you know it's safe for her and for all the other littles out there?
Well, so it's a really important question, because the two big things we want to know before we give anything to our kids are, is it safe and is it effective, right? And so the good news is we have now high quality clinical trials for both of the vaccine options for kids under 5, the Pfizer and the Moderna vaccines. There were thousands of children who participated in these trials. These children were followed for a significant period of time, both during and then after their vaccination. And here's what we learned from those trials. We learned that the vaccine actually is remarkably safe. The side effects that were seen were the kind of side effects you typically see with vaccines: soreness of the arm where the injection was given, fever, fatigue, irritability. And those generally lasted for around 24 hours, and then they resolved. And this is actually similar to the pattern we've seen with older kids as well. But what did happen is that children were left with protection. So kids who were vaccinated were less likely to get infected. The other thing is they looked at the antibody levels, and the antibodies are those proteins that your body makes to help fight infection. And it turned out that kids who were vaccinated had levels of these neutralizing antibodies that were actually similar to what adults had. And we know that those level of antibodies in adults confers protection on them. So from both standpoints, there was good evidence that that these vaccines are effective in our kids. And what we've seen with older kids, interestingly, is very important, is that the vaccines are actually helping keep them out of the hospital, that the rate of hospitalization and death among kids who are vaccinated, in older kids, 5 and up who are vaccinated, is much, much lower than among kids who are not vaccinated. So we anticipate this is, we're gonna see the same pattern with kids under 5 as well. So all of that gives me confidence, you know, as somebody who has, you know, certainly prescribed vaccines for many people over the years, who's looked at these clinical trials closely, who's talked to the FDA and the CDC over the last year plus about these kind of trials. It gives me confidence that this is safe for my child, it's effective. And again, I wanna do everything I can, like I know every parent and grandparent does out there, to protect my kid from COVID, which brings me to the last point, which is that there's still a lot of COVID around, right? So COVID has not gone away. I know a lot of things have gotten better, thankfully, because of vaccines and treatments and masks and tests that are more available now than ever before. But we still have hundreds of thousands of people who are getting infected each day with COVID. And so we've got to take the precautions we can now. I wouldn't wait until later to vaccinate your child. Sooner is better because, again, there's a lot of COVID around.
Yeah, I think many of us have gotten a sense of complacency almost. I even noticed the hand sanitizer dispensers are all empty. And that's like a sign that people think it's over when it is far from over. But we together can help expedite it being over by all getting vaccinated. So that's important. A question that we get over and over again in our community is, if I have a choice of vaccines, should I get my under 5 a Moderna or a Pfizer? What are your thoughts?
Well, the good news is that we have two options that are both safe and effective that were unanimously approved by both the FDA and CDC advisory groups, and then again endorsed by the FDA and CDC. So that's the good news. There are some differences between these vaccines. So the Moderna vaccine for under 5s is a 2-dose vaccine. And it's a higher dose. It's about a quarter of the dose of what the adults get. The Pfizer vaccine, on the other hand, is a 3-dose vaccine. So it's given over a longer period of time as well. And so the bottom line is that these are both effective, but there is a difference in the number of doses that you have to get. And the dosage also for the Pfizer vaccine is lower. So the bottom line is it's okay to get the vaccine that's available to you. And you might find when you go to your pediatrician's office that they have only one, or maybe they'll have both, but either one that you get will be able to provide your children with protection. Last thing to keep in mind is it's important to get the full course. So if you're getting Pfizer, you should get all 3 doses. If you're getting Moderna, you should get both doses to make sure you get the maximum level of protection.
And if you have a feeling that, you know, you may not be able to book appointments for 3 and you have the opportunity to do it in 2, perhaps that's your better option. Maybe it's just a logistical question, but both offer the same level of protection cumulatively if you have the full course.
Yeah, both will give you good protection. And I know some people have asked, well, can you compare them? Does one give you better protection than the other? It's actually hard to compare the trials that were done directly. They were done, again, with different numbers of kids in different times and different parts of the country and the world. And so we have to be cautious about comparing those numbers directly. The bottom line is that they do give protection, and particularly, our feeling is that when it comes to protecting you against the worst outcomes of COVID, hospitalization and death, that's really where both of these vaccines, will do a good job.
Absolutely. So the kids might still get a mild illness, but less, far less likely to get something serious.
That's right. And that's why, I've gotten my 5-year-old vaccinated. It's why we're going to be taking our 4-year-old to get vaccinated as soon as possible, is because we know that if they're vaccinated, even if they get infected, it'll likely be mild. And most importantly, they'll be protected against the worst outcomes of COVID, hospitalization and death. You know, I've had, a child hospitalized before. My 4-year-old was hospitalized when she was 1 for a non-COVID related infection. And I know how scary that can be to see your child in the hospital, to not know if they're going to be okay. After that experience in particular, I would never want that experience for any parent out there. But sadly, thousands of parents have had that experience because of COVID-19. We now have a way to help make the likelihood that your child ends up in the hospital much, much lower. And I just want every parent to have the opportunity to give their kids that protection.
And that's such a relief. So is it better to, I'm assuming it's best to get your child vaccinated ASAP as opposed to waiting until we're closer to fall and going back to school and that kind of thing, when in the fall there might be a surge. Would you say let's just get it done now, and then, you know, when boosters are available, you might be doing it one more time?
I think it's important to start sooner rather than later with, you know, vaccinating your child under five, because keep in mind, there is still a lot of COVID around. We are registering about 100,000 cases a day, but again, that doesn't include a lot of the home tests that are being done. So there are probably several hundred thousand people a day who are getting infected with COVID-19. But that level of infection around, you want to make sure that your child has protection. And again, part of the reason that despite that level of infection, we're not seeing hospitalizations go up at the same rate as we saw earlier is because we have so many more people in our country vaccinated, and because we have more treatments available. So now that young kids under five have the opportunity to be brought into that fold of protection from the vaccine, we want to make sure they get that as soon as possible. And lastly, just keep in mind this, that these vaccines are both 2 and 3 dose regimens, Moderna 2 doses, Pfizer 3 doses. So it takes a little while to get all those doses and get your child a full level of protection. That's why starting earlier is better.
How long are the vaccines spaced out?
Here's how the dosage works. With the Moderna vaccine, it's a 2-dose vaccine. So you get the first dose, and then 4 weeks later, you get the second dose.
Okay.
With the Pfizer vaccine, this is a 3-dose vaccine. So you get your first dose, 3 weeks later, you get your second dose. And then about 8 weeks after that, you're eligible to get your third dose. So again, it takes a number of weeks to get up to the full level of protection. And that's why we want people to start that series as quickly as possible.
Yeah, you might as well get started. Now, if a baby has routine vaccines scheduled anyway, they're due for their well baby checkup. And we all know the first year and beyond comes with a lot of vaccines that are really important and are routine. So is it better to space out the routine vaccines with the COVID vaccine, or can all the vaccines be done at one time? Or is that up to the pediatrician to decide?
Well, while it's certainly up to a parent and a pediatrician to decide, it is safe to give the COVID vaccine at the same time when your child is getting other vaccines. And look, we just recently took our 4-year-old to get a set of vaccines. And I remember at that time thinking, gosh, we can just get as many as possible.
Yes.
To bring her back again for another set of vaccines. That'll be easier for her as well, so she won't have the anticipation of, waiting for another visit where she knows shots are coming. So, I think if your child has a checkup that's coming in, let's say within a few days or within a week or two, then I think it's okay to combine that visit with your vaccine visit. But I'd be hesitant about waiting too much longer than that, because again, you know, with COVID, circulating as much as it is right now, we know that kids, are likely to be exposed. And with summer coming as well, and summer's already here for a lot of kids who have finished the spring, set of classes, they may want to go to summer camps, and be involved in other activities with family and visit friends around the country. We want people to be able to do that safely. So I want parents to know that it's okay to give them together so you can get them over with and get your child again started with that protection as soon as
possible. And also I would say, because parents have a hard time getting time to book an appointment to get to the pediatrician, and especially over the last 2 years may have fallen behind on routine vaccines. So this is probably a good opportunity to catch up on all vaccines if you're going to be headed there anyway.
Absolutely. And if I could just also make a plug for parents, I know that in the last couple of years that parents out there have sacrificed a lot, including their own health, to make sure that their family's okay, that their kids are okay. So in terms of falling behind on preventive care, I know a lot of parents may have neglected their own care as well. Yeah. So my hope is that parents can use some of this time over the summer to make your own primary care visits, to make sure you're taking care of your health, because your kids need you for the long run. And if you're healthy and happy, they're more likely to be healthy and happy as well.
Great. Now, if it's really hard to book an appointment at the pediatrician, I know my grandson, they've had to book them 3 months in advance. So are there other places I can go to get a vaccine for my under five?
Yes, I'm glad you asked. And this is something that we've been working really hard on to make sure that there are a lot of options for parents in terms of where they get their children vaccinated. What we heard very clearly from parents is that they ideally would like to get vaccinated at a place that's familiar to them. So that's often their doctor's office or local community health center or a children's hospital. So we have certainly worked hard to get vaccines to those locations. So if your doctor does not have the vaccine or doesn't have time in the schedule for you to come in, I would certainly check with your local health department, with your local children's hospital, and with your local community health centers, because these are all places where you could get vaccinated. We've also been working with pharmacies as well to make sure that more and more pharmacies have stores of the vaccine so that they can get and administer the vaccine to kids who may need that option. And finally, just keep in mind that on vaccines.gov, the site that we've been using for adults and older kids to help them figure out where to get vaccines, in the coming days, we will also be making more and more places where vaccine is available on that site so that families can go check out vaccines.gov and find places where they can get vaccinated. The bottom line is we want as many options as possible for parents. And I know this is all in addition to the local pop-up clinics and other activities that local communities are deciding to make available. And we're supporting them on that as well.
So thank you so much, Dr. Murthy. Really appreciate your answers to our questions.
Of course. No, I'm really happy to be with you today to talk about kids' vaccines. I lastly just want to emphasize just how big a moment this is. We have been waiting so long, those of us who are parents and grandparents of kids under five, for this chance to protect our kids. And now every age group in the country, 6 months and up, now is eligible for a vaccine and can be protected against COVID-19. That is a really big deal. It's a milestone for our country. But you know, it only really matters if people go out there and get vaccinated. So in addition to thinking about your own child, make sure you talk to your friends and other family members who may have kids under five. Let them know that the vaccine is now available. What we've seen even with vaccines for older kids and for adults is that often it's word of mouth that helps people.
Word of mom.
I like that even better.
Word of dad. No, absolutely. And I'm telling all the moms out there right now that if you can, get your child vaccinated as soon as possible and help keep them protected. Thank you, Dr. Murthy.
Thank you so much, Heidi. It's always good to see you. Thanks for all the great work you're doing to help people understand more about the vaccine.